Hello friends and welcome back to this place again, and today we are continuing our vocabulary series and I am going to discuss some more words related to phobia. I have done already 3 parts and only 2 parts are left. So basically we are going to do 5 videos on words which are related to word phobia. The root word is phobia. So without delay, let us start our today's video. As we have already discussed that phobia is a type of irrational fear. Fear from, you can see, emptiness, motion, stillness, work and so on. Now, how to use these videos? I have already discussed this thing, but here I am telling you again. If you want, you can take your pen and notebook and can write down all these words and can revise again and again whenever you want and need. Moreover, if you are not that much free to write the words, then you have to just listen the video very carefully. You can repeat the video, you can check which phobia you know and which you don't know, which word is new for you. So basically in 5 videos I'm trying to cover almost near about 100 phobias, and this is the 4th part. And the first word for today's video is kenophobia. Kenophobia is phobia of emptiness. Now this phobia is also, yes, of course, irrational fear of emptiness. In such a phobia, person is not willing to see empty spaces, or if there is some empty space in their house, they just want to cover it up, they just want to fill it up. So such a phobia is called kenophobia. Next phobia is kinesophobia. Kinesophobia is phobia of motion. You must have seen some people who are not willing to travel in vehicles because they are not, you know, comfortable with continuous motion. So such a phobia is called kinesophobia. Next phobia is kleptophobia. Kleptophobia is phobia of thieves. And one word related to kleptophobia is kleptomania. That is a habit of, you know, steal something. And kleptophobia is phobia of thieves. And we can also say that this is phobia of theft. So kleptophobia is such a phobia. Next is lalophobia, and this is phobia of speaking. Such people, those who are not willing to speak more and those who are basically of shy nature and prevent speaking, is in lalophobia. Next is logophobia. Logophobia is phobia of words. Means if somebody is afraid of using a lot of words and he or she is not willing to read a lot of words, they are just afraid of words, such a phobia is called logophobia. Next phobia is lophobia. Lophobia is phobia of a poison. One more word for poisons phobia we can use is toxicophobia, that I may discuss in my next video. So such a phobia, which is a fear of a poison, is called lophobia. Next word is lygophobia. Lygophobia is phobia of darkness. If someone is afraid of dark places, and you must have, you know, seen people, those who are not willing to go to the dark during night. So such a person is, you know, facing lygophobia because he or she is afraid of darkness. They always want to be in some nearby light area. So this phobia of darkness is called lygophobia. Next phobia is lysophobia. Lysophobia is phobia of getting mad. Means, of course, who wants to get mad? If somebody is afraid of getting mad, is suffering from lysophobia. Next is megalophobia. Megalophobia is phobia of large or big things. means if somebody is afraid of things which are very large in size is suffering from megalophobia. The word after megalophobia is melizophobia. Melizophobia is phobia of bees. Means if somebody is afraid of bees and beehives, he or she is suffering from melizophobia. Next phobia is musophobia, and this phobia is also called icophobia. Now here you can relate this phobia with this word muso from word mouse. So this phobia is, yes, of course, is phobia from mice. If generally you can see this phobia in girls, maybe of course it is possible that boys also may afraid of mice, but what I have seen is generally girls are more afraid from mouse. So such a phobia in which a person is afraid of mice is called musophobia or icophobia. Next word is necrophobia. Necrophobia is phobia of dead bodies. Means if somebody is not able to see any corpses or any dead bodies, so such a phobia is called necrophobia. Next phobia is nosophobia. Nosophobia is phobia of illness. Means if somebody is afraid of getting ill, he or she is not willing to go to the doctor, is suffering from nosophobia. Basically, this phobia is of getting ill. This, please don't get confused. This phobia is not a phobia of going to doctor, but yes, this phobia is phobia of getting ill. Next is nyctophobia. Nyctophobia is phobia of night. Those who are afraid of night and generally they are not going outside during night, such phobia is called nyctophobia. And next phobia is oclophobia. Oclophobia is phobia of mobs. Means crowded places are not for such people. If there are lots of people around them, they are not comfortable, those who are suffering from oclophobia. They generally don't want to go to such places where a lot of people are there, and they generally avoid in such events, you know, going in such events. Next is ombrophobia. Ombrophobia is phobia of rain. It's, you know, I don't know how can someone afraid of rain, but yes, there's such phobia. Ombrophobia. Ombrophobia is phobia from rain. Though this word belongs to them, those who are not those who don't like rain, and those people who are not going outside during the rain, they just afraid of rain. So such a phobia is called ombrophobia. Next word is ophidiophobia. Ophidiophobia is phobia of snakes. Those who are, you know, afraid of snakes. Yes, I think almost all of us are afraid of snakes. But a few people they cannot see snakes directly, indirectly. They cannot see it in any movie or something. They are so afraid of snakes. Such a phobia is called ophidiophobia. Next phobia is ornithophobia. Ornithophobia is phobia of birds. Next word is orophobia. Orophobia is phobia of mountains. Those who are suffering from orophobia, they never travel to mountains. Means they avoid traveling to mountains. They are not willing to go to hilly areas, hill stations. So such a phobia is called orophobia. Next and the last word for today's video is orthophobia. Orthophobia is phobia of property. They don't want to collect property and they are afraid of it. So such a phobia is called orthophobia. So friends, this is it for today. I hope these video sessions are very useful to you. And if you want to see some particular topic in vocabulary session, you can write down in comment section. Till then, keep watching, keep learning.